Good evening. Hi, I'm Kill the Vid, your host for the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And I'm back again with another edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate, the Dreadful Crimes DLC. This is going to be Gaming Livestream Walkthrough Episode 4. In the previous episode, I kind of saw two back-to-back cases. The first case involved around a missing detective who, it turns out that he was inexplicably murdered by a person who turns out to be selling the body parts in the form of consumables, which of course screams Sweeney Todd. And then that following case consisted of a professor who had died, and yeah, it's kind of complicated to explain, but it was that. Anyway, I solved that case, so we're moving on to some more unsolved cases with the Dreadful Crime DLC in Assassin's Creed Syndicate. So grab a snack, grab a drink, grab what you need. It's time for Let's Play Classic between Assassin's Creed Syndicate, right now on the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. Here we go. Just gotta make sure I get the video capture. Bear with me. Okay, we got visual. Good. All right, very good. So we're ready to roll. Thank you. We're gonna move on to the next case. Don't know how many are remaining dedicated to this segment or this DLC for Dreadful Crimes, but if we're on the last one, I will be moving on with the other DLC for Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which of course are two episodic features, one of them being Jack the Ripper, the notorious precursor serial killer that stalked streets of London in the Whitechapel district in the 1880s, specifically 1888, and it still remains unsolved as of 2024. One of the longest It's one of the longest running, standing cold cases in world history, and most of your, and of course in London, England, the United Kingdom as well. So anyway, let's go to the next dreadful crime location. Ah, here we are. Hop, skip, and a jump from here. The most hated man in London. The reward is £2,500 and 1,000 XP. Let's do it. That's it, let's go get my squad here.
I'm on your side, Mr. Frye.
And for these cases, you don't have to use the use of a weapon, except for when you're encountering rival gangs and the police on the streets. When it comes to doing these cases, there's no action sequences. Just straight up clean detective work. Except for this.
How's that?
Right, get it. Everybody get on board.
That is a doornail. And good riddance.
Ready. Normally, I just loot the bodies whenever I take them out, but this time I'm in a hurry, so skip that. I don't engage with the police unless I have to. Which I don't, most times don't, unless they see me committing violence on the street. Dreadful crimes. The most hated man in London. Deduce which of all the potential murderers actually killed Ashton.
Thank you. Think of that. Crushed by a crate. The most hated man in London.
Can you imagine achieving such a title? One day my brilliance will bring me similar recognition.
Mr. Raymond, what are you talking about?
It's of no consequence. What's important is that this man was hated by many, but who delivered the fatal blow?
One's harassing my buddies. And I'll continue with the investigation.
Won't bite back now, will you?
Good riddance to bad rubbish.
So let's continue on with the games.
Come on.
Yep, I can do it. What a horrible way to go out. Street Ashton's body. The body has been crushed by the crate, but close inspection reveals other anomalies. A puncture wound to the gut, a bullet wound in the back, and the victim's skin has an odd green parlor along with yellowing around the eye. Inspection of the bullet wound indicates that such a wound would cause death in 12 minutes. Ashton's agenda. Listed daily activities. Pharmacy, 1 o'clock p.m. Pub, 1:05 p.m. Apple, 1:09 p.m. Household account, 1:10 p.m. What's his time to? Crawling with cops. On your
side, mate. Harder. I'm a clear shot.
I've seen this many cops. So many cops here.
Finish you!
Chased by the cop.
I think I'll run home as fast as I can.
My help at. Police brutality! Police brutality! Stop! Police brutality! Police brutality! Police brutality! Cops won't die. I think this is a bug. Come on, get away from me. Cops won't die. Yeah, so many cops at me. Look at it.
Catch up with you, mate.
You are dead. You don't stand a chance.
Not the way I had in mind when it came to starting the case. But I am to blame for all this.
Thank you. That's far enough. No time to explain.
Dr. Chester, concerned passerby.
I know the man. He's hated by everyone. Surprisingly, it's not clear what killed him. I find multiple wounds. No need to send many people to jail for killing such a terrible man. What say you only arrest the single person who actually caused his death?
I suspect that there is at least one deadly toxin in his system.
He appears to have been stabbed with a perforating weapon, perhaps a spike of some kind. There would be bleeding, and it would affect motor control right away, but death wouldn't come for another 6 minutes.
Means he was poisoned or something. When the cops are highlighted, this, I guess they can't be killed. So there's three more clues in this area. I gotta find out what and where they are.
When ready. Your badge up your ass.
Oh no.
has a single bite taken out of it. The inside of the apple is out of pink. The apple must have been poisoned. That's what it was. Apple was poisoned.
He's my husband. Each day I bring him the household expenses just after he eats his apple. I also brought him his invitation to the knighthood ceremony. The one with the special scepter. Of course, he wasn't going to take me along.
He stopped by here every day at the exact same time. He'd buy an apple and try to cheat me out of tuppence. But then most folks do that.
Tie up my hair around a knitting needle. What business is it of yours?
Ah! not for you.
Newspaper includes an interesting article. Henrik's refinery brought to a halt. Apparent sabotage has destroyed machinery at Lawrence Hendricks' foundry. Rumors circulating imply that industrialist John Ashton is behind the sabotage of his competitor.
The Queen's menagerie.
Someone else over here. Come on. The Webley Boxer Revolver. One chamber, is it?
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
Only firing one shot.
Ashton stops in front of this pub every afternoon to check on business rumors. Something of a bastard, Ashton. Told me he had a bit of jam on the side, if you know what I mean. Wife didn't know about it. Well, a bit of jam wants out, but he won't let her. That's the sort of fellow we're speaking of. That was Ashton's doing. The man had it in for me. He paid workers to wreck my machines. Cost me a fortune. As long as he was around, I'd never prosper.
As a matter of fact, I do carry a revolver at all times. It can be a dangerous neighborhood for a wealthy fella such as myself. This proves nothing.
I say, stop that at once!
He's been coming to me for years. He arrives precisely at 1 o'clock and leaves 2 minutes later.
He takes a bluish medication every day and prefers that I administer it. Mary is a trusted assistant. As far as I know, she's completely above board. Today, she swept the shop and prepared some medications. She also fetched herself an apple from the apple stand.
I see him here every day. He can be unpleasant, but I don't really know him.
Pharmaceutical cabinet. Contains chemicals labeled warning, not to be ingested. Chemical 1 is bluish in color and is listed as causing erratic movement after 10 minutes and death after an additional 16 minutes. Causes jaundice about the eyes and has an extreme anesthetic effect. I'm thinking Mary might have done it. Chemical 2 is pinkish in color. That's on the apple, so she poisoned the apple and is listed as causing erratic movement after 2 minutes and death after an additional 9 minutes. Yields a green tint to skin. Was a conspirator. Drugs. Got here. Letter addressed to Thomas Reese, pharmacist. Tom, my dear brother, I have recently made a most unsettling discovery. Unsettling discovery? The man who forced the foreclosure of the family farm was none other than John Ashton, your very client. His behavior in this affair is beyond indecent. Both father and mother are reduced to penury. You and I both must concentrate all we can, although we each have obligations of our own. At the very least, you must cease to do business with this dreadful man.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions. Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
Mary is a trusted assistant. As far as I know, she's completely above board. Today, she swept the shop and prepared some medications. She also fetched herself an apple from the apple stand.
This really is none of your business. He came to me for his blue medication. I gave him blue medication.
He seems defensive and the least bit forthcoming with information. I think he's a suspect as well. Plus that letter as well. Doesn't directly indicate a murder plot. got here? Medicine box. Medicine box of Ashton's prescription on with a few remaining blue pills. He must have dropped it along the way. Okay, all clues and all suspects have been interrogated, and all clues have been checked around this area.
You fancy some fun?
I thought you'd never ask.
Be right back. Okay, I'm back with Assassin's Creed Syndicate, DLC Dreadful Crimes, Gaming Livestream Walkthrough Episode 4, and I'm still doing the first case here, and I tried to get two cases on this stream, at least. So, let's continue. So this is a case about, it's called The Most Hated Man. In London. The most hated man in London. So, it says here, John Ashton has many enemies with both the means and opportunity to murder him. But no matter how many attempts were made on his life, only one is the actual cause of death. Which one? The body has been crushed by the crate, but close inspection reveals other anomalies. A puncture wound to the gut, a bullet wound in the back, and the victim's skin has an odd green pallor along with yellowing around the eyes. Inspection of the bullet would indicate that such a wound would cause death in 12 minutes. Ashton's agenda. This was his timetable of his day-to-day. Listed daily activities included pharmacy, 1 o'clock, pub, 105, apple, 109, household account, 1:10 p.m. Which was where he was last, before a crate crushed him. So let's continue on. So we did the street, kind of the street, but we didn't get all the clues, per se.
Keep moving.
Plus, there's a lot of police activity.
That's
over there.
The way.
Too many PCs are over there.
Doing fine, girl.
Meanwhile, I need a
easy now.
Purchase from the merchant.
Need help surviving the streets.
Don't I ever. Now let's try to go back to the streets, but watch out for the cops. This whole area is crawling with them. There's some additional clues here that I didn't touch on. Okay, the footprints. Something here. Oh yeah, that was the crate. Okay, here's something here. Right, I gotta be careful, this is an unstable area. Otherwise it will cause desynchronization. Like I'm developing an acquired taste for black coffee, because usually I take mine with cream. But they say that black coffee is actually by itself without anything in it, maybe a little sugar or agave nectar like what I use, but they said that black coffee is much more potent when it comes to waking you up, unless you're a caffeine sensitive person. I'm not. But then I don't mess around with energy drinks, as I've mentioned countless times on my stream. I heard that an American drank 10 of them, and as a result, his heart gave out and he died. And it's also mentioned that the extent of caffeine a person can consume, should not consume, is any more than 480 milligrams. And which means, take those monsters for example, they range anywhere between 120 to 160 milligrams of caffeine. So, the person who consumed, who took too many of those, had so much caffeine in them that it ended up killing them. But often do you hear about people overdosing off of coffee, caffeine and coffee. But stay out of this. I have a case to solve. Maybe that will create a distraction to get the cops off. Watch, his pocket watch. Broken pocket watch inscribed John Ashton. Stopped at 117 precisely. So I got one last clue in this area. This thing looks out of the ordinary. Can't go beyond this point, otherwise I'll desynchronize the building. What's this? Okay, I got the damn watch. What's this? Separate. Yep, there's the crate. There's two items. The crate. Okay, we got them. Appears to have fallen from overhead crane onto Ashton. We need to go over to them. Whoever was manning the crate might have been the one trying to kill that killed off Ashton. The character is called John Ashton, but there's an actor named John Ashton, American actor, who was better known for playing Sergeant Taggart in the Beverly Hills Cop movies. Okay, there's the crane over there.
Draw and shoot!
That must be the crane off, right? Oh look, there's some evidence right here. Handbill. Please contribute to the benefit fund for the man who had his arm crushed. Any help would be much appreciated.
I should go back and ask about this.
Construction site. Crane. A huge coal-powered crane. The driving mechanism is complex and requires an expert operator.
I should return and find out about this.
What do you want from me? I'll give you anything. Anything you ask. Mercy! Let me go!
He owned this site and paid us. We all hated him because he looked for any excuse to cheat us out of our wages. I didn't hate him any more or less than my mates.
So this guy might could be the prime suspect. But here's the timetable.
That's around the time I'm given a few minutes to eat something. About then I would have been buying myself an apple at the stand down the street.
So in other words, he must have killed during the lunch hour. If he's our man.
It's difficult to work properly. You'd have to know what you're doing to drop it at just the right moment.
Because that's the perfect opportunity, and he had opportunity to kill Ashton.
The man's a right bastard.
Or him.
Smoldering in hell.
Well, I'm not a crane operator. I wouldn't know how to work that.
He's telling the truth.
My best chum is maimed for life, and Ashton didn't care a fig. He deserved what happened. Beyond that, I'm mum.
Okay. One other.
Eddie? Yeah. I told him how to work the crane a few days ago.
Oh, and he lied about using the crane, so more likely, Eddie's the man. But I still need to go back down over there before I make my accusation. Make sure I have all clues in hand and I'll interview all suspects. But when you make the wrong accusation, the amount of the reward goes down. So I gotta be careful of that.
Extra threepence. She had a special app just for Mr. Ashton. I gave that one when he come by.
Trying to poison.
Yeah, that sounds right. Came by for an apple. He was here when we heard the crate hit the ground.
Yep, so it was Eddie that killed him.
Mr. Ashton did look strange like. Eyes all yellowish. And then he turned pale after he bit into the apple. Almost green, really.
I think I'm about ready to make the accusation. Got to interview just about everybody. Got the pub, pharmacy, all other locales. I'm probably just about ready to make an accusation. But whoever operated the crane is the one who killed Ashton. So it wasn't Frank, because Frank was getting an apple, and the merchant can attest that Frank was there at the scene, which leaves Eddie was the one who killed him. So I'm about to ready to go make the accusation. He lied about not knowing how to use the crane. So it was definitely Eddie. Could be wrong, but I do believe it was Eddie. Frank was the one who went and got the app. This is Frank. Okay, that's Frank. So now, this leaves Eddie. Here we go.
It was me for certain. I watched the crate fall and crush him. He was still moving when
confession. Confession. Got him. Take him away, boys. Oop. I guess I was wrong. Oh, great. The roll money just went down. Great. But who else is there? Oh. So, the doctor doesn't know how to operate the crane, so it might be Frank. No one else knows how to operate the crane, but either Frank or Eddie. So, it might have been Frank.
I was off eating an apple when it happened. Blimey.
Oh, great. So both of the crane workers didn't do it. Oh, dear. The reward money is going down. Because he took a bite out the apple, got poisoned, and dropped it.
This is why London's gone to the dogs.
I often tie up my hair around a knitting needle. Business is it of yours? He's my husband. Each day I bring him the household expenses just after he eats his apple. I also brought him his invitation to the knighthood ceremony, the one with the special scepter. Of course, he wasn't going to take me along.
I think the crane dropped on him incidentally. So it wasn't really the crane. So it's the doctor at the pharmacy. So the crane fell incidentally. But the man was already dead when the crate crushed him. The man was already dead. According to the examination. pharmacy. Definitely wasn't the wife. Now account for your whereabouts, Mary.
I see him here every day. He can be unpleasant, but I don't really know him. Quite right. I asked the apple seller to give him a special apple. Is that a crime? He was a horrid man. That's all I have to say.
Because whatever killed quickly, the shot didn't kill him. Because the gunshot didn't kill him. Quick didn't kill him, so it was definitely the poison. Was definitely the poison. But doesn't mean that the doctor was the killer. We gotta find out who's the one that fired the gun at him, but it wasn't that film. So I think it's the woman. I think it's the woman. Does she poison apple or the apple? Let me look at the case photos. The case photos. We'll determine what was what killed Ashton. So looking at the body, see what it says here. A puncture wound to the gut, bullet wound in the back, and the victim's skin. Death would have been in 12 minutes. But the apple. Because poisons tend to be fast acting. I'm gonna go on a limb and bite the bullet with this one.
I'm not that clever with poisons. It's pure luck that I'm the one that killed him.
I don't believe the timing of the poison indicates that I'm the one killed the man. More's the pity.
Oh, great. More money's going down. Oh, well. This is pathetic. I'm really bad for this. Could be the wife. Because I'm accusing everybody another question. So it could be the wife. Gordon, when he gone down, not nearly half. Argument with the wife. But the wife could be the one.
Very well. I found out about his dalliance with that girl from the pharmacy. It's not the first. Divorce is all but impossible given his influence with the clergy. I'll be the toast of the town.
A very unpleasant fellow. But what was that business about a knighthood ceremony?
Oh, she did it.
In any case, Mr. Raymond will have a story for Perlock Publishing.
Take her away. Was the wife all along? The most hated man in London, or more than one way to skin a cat? Wealthy business owner, John Ashton was murdered not once but five times. So hated was this business that his business rival, his employee, his wife, his mistress, and his pharmacist all made attempts on his life. Poisoned, shot, stabbed, and finally crushed. Ashton came to a very gruesome end indeed. Henry Raymond. See how bad the reward money was. Ain't that bad. Should accuse the wife straight away, but oh well. First instance, I accused a woman of murder that did it. Move on to the next case straight away. That's what the Brits say. Straight away! Oh, here we are, in Lambeth. Next stop, murder, which involves a train. The reward is £2,500 and 1,000 XP. I think I'm gonna fast travel for this one. She was the one who shot him and dumped the gun in the pub. Shot him in his back.
Thank you. Watch on now.
Fire!
Excellent shot.
Won't bite back now, will you?
One less.
Serves you bloody well right.
Up to the next crimes, to the next cake.
Steady on. Walk on, girl.
Sorry.
Let's go. Who's a good horse? You are.
I think I'll switch to Evie. It has to do with a train. A murder on a train. Solve the mystery of the body found on the banks of the Thames. So it wasn't a train. Expect the unidentified body.
Shoot now!
Standing ready if you need help, Evie.
Now, child.
Is she all right, do you reckon?
I mean, the
left eyes have got no stop.
Someone help!
Watch this.
Good serves you right. Bad rubbish.
To the river bank. Okay, there's the body. Male body dressed in the manner of a wealthy man. Let me read that again. Male body dressed in the manner of a wealthy businessman. He is wearing only one shoe. The man has sustained multiple fractures indicating a fall from a great height. There are no identifying documents. In other words, he has no identification. He's an unidentified man. Let's follow the tracks. So the body was dragged. Drag marks. Let's follow them. Impact. So the body was dropped. Probably, presumably by two people. Two unidentified persons.
I heard a splash, and right quick pulled this bloke out of the shallows. Dead as a mackerel.
In other words, he was thrown in the Thames, and then he was brought over here by the homeless man.
I live there now, if you can call it living. I lost my job, didn't I? No need for the likes of me when a machine can do the work.
Clothes. Coat. A rich man's coat with a name severed in the lining. Matthew Killian. That's how the body is identified. Which means the coat. The vagrant used the opportunity to take his coat.
I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect.
So the vagrant so far is a prime suspect. And felt embittered that he lost his job. However, it still doesn't prove that he committed the murder.
A nice warm coat like that on a dead man? What do you expect? I snatched it before somebody else came along to nick it. Like you.
Okay, good point. Don't need it. Get up on the bridge. There's one more clue in this area. I'm out of the investigation zone. So I need to get up above where the fall took place. So it's a railway connected to a railway. Oh, here we go. There's something. Pocket watch. A broken silver watch. The hands have stopped just after midnight. That means the watch was working.
Well now, I didn't ask about this.
The man was alive.
Midnight train, that must be the 616. Stops in the station down the road. If you hurry, it might still be there.
Let's go out to the train. The train, Victoria train station.
Here now.
Get on board.
There you go.
Sure, everybody.
I'll cover you.
Go on.
Pull together!
Easy. Easy.
How's
that? 3,500 pound reward. I'll take it.
Slowly. There you are.
Come now! I see that glint in your eye. You're in the mood to shop. Everything you've ever...
So of course this is the last hour of this stream, and I'm also on the last case of this stream. Get out.
It's leaving right now.
No clues in this area. So I had it. There's three people out there.
Pardon me, my dear. My arm is tingling.
Clumsy fool!
Clumsy fool! Restaurant carriage, passenger carriage, sleeper, sleeper two. Oh shit, that's the train. Get on board. Yep, so it does involve a train after all.
It was a typical evening. As far as I knew, nothing unusual happened until you came aboard with this story of a murder.
You know a Killian?
Just another wealthy passenger. They're all pretty much the same.
Thank you. So, somebody threw him off. Killed him on the train and then threw him off and carted the body, so it wasn't the Vengry. Don't mind if I do. Sleeping pills. A small box of sleeping pills. It's half empty.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
Which means Killian was drugged. His drink was drugged.
Tidying up in the passenger car. Around midnight, Vivian ran through. She thought someone was looking for her.
Peter. Let's go.
Unusual. A couple of passengers came in and had a sort of business meeting. One of them was buying a lot of drinks for the other, and then they started to argue. But Vivian went over and joshed them out of it.
Vivian Peter, must have been the wife of the lady friend.
Came here after being sacked from a foundry a few months ago. I tell you, he looked white as a ghost after he served the businessmen.
Peter might be a prisoner.
Well, it's a noisy train. Plenty of passengers have trouble getting to sleep, so I keep a sedative here behind the bar, yeah?
Okay. It might have been the person that served him. That Dunaway. Into the City of London station. close up the people's faces. How about you? Can you account for your movements? You're Luke.
Building noise. Some noises on the roof woke me up briefly. You say someone was thrown from up there. You have to be a very strong fella to drag someone up onto the roof. Vivian had another of her dupes in her compartment by then. After that, I remember people going past me from time to time, but I was half asleep. Killian was on this train. Cool. I used to work in his foundry. I never even seen him. None of us workers ever knew what he looked like.
What about Peter?
Peter worked with me at the foundry. He's a very strong bloke. I got my arm mangled in one of the damn machines they put in. Then Killian sacked the old crew. Peter, he helped me get hired as train star.
I'm thinking Peter could be the suspect. Look for so many clues. Or look on the dinner table on the train. Okay, here we go. There's something. Newspaper. An article about Matthew Killian's efforts to close an enormous business deal in Wales. It notes that Killian is well known for replacing workers with machinery. There is a likeness of Killian in the paper which matches the victim. Pamphlets. Down with the industrialists! Down with the monarchy! Revolution is the only way! It's a propaganda pamphlet. So he had a proletariat or a Bolshevik propaganda. So, that's probably what he was. So we need to find Peter. Because, more than likely, he had opportunity. I want to make sure I've got everything before I make an obvious accusation. So there's two other people. Thank you. Angus Wolf.
I suppose there were some disagreements, but there always are when a great deal of money is involved. I had drinks in the dining car with Killian. We had business dealings in the past. It was a pleasant surprise to discover him on this train.
Okay, here's something here. Okay, there's a gun. That means the man was shot. Obviously shot. It's a derringer. A small ivory-plated derringer. Chamber for two bullets. But one is missing, which means the gun was fired. Letter. Sleeper 1. Letter. Killian will be on the 616 train to Cardiff to sign the papers. You must prevent him from signing them at all costs, or we shall be ruined. So, it was an injunction to prevent an order to from Killian to lay off some workers.
Mr. Wolf had a few with Mr. Killian. Sam. Then the young lady invited herself over to have a glass with him. Mr. Wolf bought him drink after drink. Then they got angry. But the young lady come over and it's obvious that Mr. Killian was interested in a rendezvous like. Around about 11:30, Killian and her left together. Mr. Wolf bought him drink after drink. Then they got angry. But the young lady come over and it's obvious that Mr. Killian was interested in a rendezvous. Mr. Wolf bought him drink after drink. I've been Mr. Wolf's valet for going on several years. He's frail and needs a man like me to help him about. Mr. Wolf became terribly tired, even though he'd only had one drink. He toddled off to bed well before midnight. I stayed in the dining car for a few drinks with the barman.
To ask about the legal document. The valet.
He's a trusted valet. He's terrifically strong, which makes him useful in many situations.
Oh, the valet.
I felt unusually tired and came back here to get some sleep.
There's the woman of interest. Handbag contains a letter.
How goes it, Viv? Got any more fish? That's a lovely caper. You've got going. I need to find a bonny scheme like that. Let's have a glass next time you're in Soho, love. Your sis.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
Oh. Woman might be involved. Might be a conspirator as well.
Nothing unusual at all. I had a drink with some gents and then retired to my sleeper. The rich fella, I did talk with him. Very charming. But a single woman has to be careful, you know? Did something happen to him? Oh, all right. I flirt with rich blokes and the barman slips him a Mickey. I take him back to my sleeper and they nod off before I have to do anything shameful. They wake up thinking they had a night of fun and hand me a few quid. That's what happened with Mr. Killian, but he was gone when I come back from looking for the man who left the note.
So she runs some kind of scheme on rich folks. What we got here? Note. A handwritten note. Come to the restaurant carriage quickly.
Well now, I didn't ask about this.
Someone slipped a note under my sleeper door a few minutes before midnight. It said I should come to the dining car. I went, but only Ryan and Wolfsman were there, and they were both drunk. The rich fella. I did...
Little minx. She and the bombman got a little scam going. I think everyone on the staff knows about it.
You gotta find the drink, man.
Frequent passenger, that one. Hangs about with the wealthier sort. Likes to entertain them, if you take my meaning.
You always ask about this game.
Yeah, I helped Vivian fleece the dupes. I slipped a pill in the wine for the table. Both gents got sleepy, but Vivian picked the richest one. Well, it's a noisy train. Hey.
Steward. So this is Peter the Steward.
Just another wealthy passenger. They're all pretty much the same. I was tidying up in the passenger car. Around midnight, Vivian ran through. She thought someone was looking for her. She rides the train often. She's very friendly with the other passengers.
Okay, now I think it's about time for me to make an accusation. I gotta find a clue here first before I make an exit. Gotta be some kind of clue.
Thank you.
last half hour of this stream. 28 minutes. About 28 minutes. Wrap up this case.
That one. Clever little minx. She and the bomb have got a little scam going. I think everyone on the staff knows about it. Work with me at the foundry. He's a very strong bloke. I got my arm mangled in one of the damn machines they put in. Then Killian sacked the old crew. Peter, he helped me get hired as train
big
star.
And Peter definitely.
Vivian had another of her dupes in her compartment by then. After that, I remember people going past me from time to time, but I was half asleep.
I'm using the Eagle Vision. I can't find the missing clue.
She rides the train often. She's very friendly with the other passengers. Just another wealthy passenger. They're all pretty much the same. I was tidying up in the passenger car. Around midnight, Vivian ran through. She thought someone was looking for her.
Could be wrong, but we're trying to make the accusation.
I gave him what he deserved.
Yep.
The man was heartless.
I did it.
I believe something larger is afoot. A lot of murderous anger concerning industrialists. Might be something to look into.
Up to the clique with you.
Taking them away. Next stop, murder. Industrious Matthew Killian was drugged and thrown from the top of a moving train by his former employee, Peter Jespers. Put out of work by the mechanization of Killian's factory, Peter found employment as a humble train steward. However, one evening, Peter realized that Killian was on his very train. Prior to his journey, Peter had never seen Killian, but now recognized him from a recent newspaper article. Peter, knowing that frequent passenger Vivian often swindled wealthy fellow passengers, waited until she lured Killian to her compartment. He cunningly arranged for her to be called away by means of an anonymous note. Peter then used his considerable strength to lift the drugging magnet and drug him to the top of the train, whence he threw him to his death at midnight. Killian's rival, Angus Wolf, had hoped to get Killian so inebriated as to prevent him from participating in the business meeting on the following day, but Wolf himself fell afoul of the drug brandy and slept through the entire episode. As for Peter, the murderer, perhaps he meted out justice. In turn, he will now meet justice himself. Henry Raymond. This time we didn't lose any money. When I accused Wright this time. See if there's any upcoming cases. Don't know how many I've done, but here's another one. Conjuring up a killing. Reward, £2,500, just like before, and 1,000 XP. Let's get a preview of that. Of course, I'm not going to get three cases on this stream. But at least just get a preview of what lies ahead.
I'd like to take this time to ask if you are enjoying the stream. If you like the content I'm bringing you, why not consider following and subscribing to the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, as I'll be producing more Let's Play gaming live stream walkthroughs such as games as Assassin's Creed Syndicate, Sleeping Dogs, and many others. And if you'd like to contribute to my channel, if you'd like to contribute to the Outlaw, me, I do have a Patreon listed in the description. You can contribute if you like. I would greatly appreciate that as well. And now, on with the stream. Gotta go check on the safe. But I'll probably do that right to get a preview. Upcoming caper. I'm at the train station. Conjuring up a killing. Charles Dickens. Saw the murder of spiritualist Thaddeus the Amazing. So it's the murder of a magician, I guess. Just gonna leave right there. That's gonna be for next time. So I can empty out the safe. You also see that there's Queen Victoria memories. The V is for Queen Victoria. Operation Locomotive. A good shot. But I think that might be with the last Maharaja, which will be coming up. This one is Charles Dickens, or Charles Darwin. Charles Dickens, recollection. Charles Darwin, an abominable mystery. This one is called Fifty Berkeley Square, Charles. So we'll just get back on the train. I'm pretty sure the safe is full to bursting, so I can empty it.
Frye Twins to hiding in plain sight.
I see the same. Watch my hand. Shaoji. Nightshade. Last 9 minutes of the stream.
Prepare for a brawl, Evie.
So I'm about to wrap up the stream in about a few minutes.
Switch back to Jacob.
My best to Greeny.
The behavior is...
Looks like I got all the outfits for Jacob.
Quite unbecoming.
So I'm 92% through the main story, 87% through the associate activities, 47% through the London stories, and 31% through the miscellaneous. And that's gonna do it for this edition of Let's Play Classic between Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Dreadful Crimes on the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. Be sure to like, follow, and subscribe to the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, as well as hitting the notification turned on so whenever I have a stream like this going. And stay tuned, because at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, my time, I will be continuing Let's Play Classic featuring Sleeping Dogs Definitive Edition on the downloadable content episode Year of the Snake. So be on the lookout for that. Until then, I'm Kill the Vid for the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And please stay safe.